We finally got the first trailer for Aquaman and the Lost Kingdom, and there are some things to glean from it. First off, it doesn't look like the special effects are quite done yet. Not exactly groundbreaking stuff when you look at the visuals, something that absolutely plagued the Flash movie, and was something almost across the board people kind of complained about. There's some other things that are hinted in there. We see opening up that Arthur Curry, played by Jason Momoa, is a father now. He and Queen Mira have had a baby, and it seems like it's going to be a big part of his life. In fact, they refer to the baby multiple times during the trailer and all that stuff, kind of hitting it home that the baby is going to play a key part of the story of Aquaman and the Lost Kingdom. And this movie has been delayed a lot, and we've been talking about it. There have been many rumors, lots and lots of rumors, that every time they try to do a test screening of this movie, people that were going in for free were actually walking out. And you're like, what could be so bad that if it was for free, it would still cost too much because it's actually costing your time? Apparently, there's something about Aquaman 2, Aquaman and the Lost Kingdom, that was turning viewers off en masse. In fact, they had to do a historical amount of reshoots on the film. And now we're getting an idea, the rumor is out there, of what actually drove people to leave the theater, even though it was free. And I gotta say, I would probably have a very similar reaction. On social media, the movie scooper account, My Time to Shine Hello, backed up a recent claim made by Grace Randolph that viewers have been walking out of free test screenings for Aquaman and the Lost Kingdom. According to rumors, viewers were particularly appalled by a scene depicting the death of Aquababy, the son of Arthur Curry in Mira. This is something many DC fans have been fearing, as in the comics, Black Manta callously killed the child. And I imagine getting introduced to Aquababy in the movie, if you're a test screener, and all of a sudden them killing off the baby, Black Manta doing it specifically, might make you walk out on the movie. And I don't think this is going to be a very good choice for them, artistically speaking, if they want the movie to be successful. Sure, I understand killing kids. It kind of works in the setting of a lot of stories because it's really something that so many people can relate to. You don't even have to be a mom or a dad, and certainly I am a dad, and I could certainly relate to the fear that goes along with that. But even also have like a little brother, little sister, any type of sibling, it's something that's going to hit you right in the feel spots, and it's hopefully going to get you to kind of dive into the story and buy into the stakes that are happening, because, oh my goodness, this is a superhero movie, and they killed a kid off here. But I don't know that superhero fare, as far as big blockbuster movie making, like killing babies off is going to be the smartest idea. Like, people were pretty not happy with the catching babies and microwave scene from the Flash movie, just because of what it like hinted at what could happen. We don't want to microwave babies. If you shut the door, bad things could happen. They didn't like that happening to babies in a superhero movie. And I imagine actually killing off Arthur Curry's offspring, Aquababy, will not go over well with mass audiences. Comic books are a different type of storytelling medium with a different audience that is predisposed to it. And yes, in comic books, I will admit, you have to get used to some pretty rough stuff. I mean, Harley Quinn in one comic book, I believe, murdered like 150 kids in Gotham just to show the Joker that she still had it in her. You know what I mean? There's been some crazy stuff going on in there. And yes, Aquababy did die in the pages of Aquaman, killed by Black Manta. Although, based off what we saw in the trailer and what we know happened in the comic book, where basically Black Manta got to Aquababy and the baby could only really survive in water, and basically, I don't know, is it asphyxiated? He exposed him to only air. He took all the water away from him, and he passed away that way in comic books. And it was a very big moment and pretty morbid stuff. So I imagine James Wan, the director of Aquaman and the Lost Kingdom, will have to do, or did do, something different, because we did see the baby obviously living on terra firma, as in that's where the baby was in the Aquaman and the Lost Kingdom trailer. It looked like Aquaman gave up being a superhero, but obviously he didn't, because now he's the king. I imagine this, people liked seeing the baby. They liked seeing Jason Momoa hold the baby, and the idea of Aquaman being a dad. So if killing the baby was a big part of the original scripts and had people walking away, if killing the baby was a big plot point, you needed to take something away, because in the trailer, Black Manta says, I'm going to take everything away from you. I'm going to take your family away. I suggest rewriting that, reshooting it, and making it be Mira instead of the baby. That would probably be something that would go over just a little bit better with audiences. But you never know, because it is Warner Brothers Discovery, and they've been doing a lot of things to turn people off. The article continues. As of now, these are unsubstantiated rumors, though it has been reported several times during production that Aquaman and the Lost Kingdom was continuing to go through many changes as a result of poor test screenings. The fate of Aquababy in the final version of the film remains unclear for now, as it's possible his death scene was scrapped if it was really causing such harsh reactions. It's also possible that the rumored scene will remain in the film if Wan wanted to stick with a comic accurate approach. What we do know is that Arthur and Mira's son is in Aquaman the Lost Kingdom, as he was revealed in the official trailer. Yes, and the baby looked very cute, and Jason Momoa looked very handsome holding the baby and being a daddy. And I don't think taking that away from people at this point in time would be a very good idea. And there were major, major issues, probably that go even further than this rumored scene where they kill the baby off, at least in the test screenings, and that was turning people off. They actually had to reshoot major portions of the film. In fact, they had three sets of reshoots after the final production on the movie because things weren't going well, which seems really odd, but it sounds like James Wan has not had a good time with the production in the making of Aquaman and the Lost Kingdom. He's mentioned multiple times every time he had the story nailed down and what they were going to do and how everything in the DCEU kind of fit into Aquaman the Lost Kingdom, something would change. Next thing you know, Aquaman would get pushed and Flash would be moved forward and they would have to scrap something or made these changes because that wasn't working and it was having a domino effect down and affecting, obviously, down the line for Aquaman the Lost Kingdom, which was supposed to be either the last or second to last DCEU movie that was going to be coming out. And it has absolutely had a detrimental effect, at least on the reputation of Aquaman and the Lost Kingdom. When I saw the trailer, I thought, yeah, these special effects don't look good, but there's kind of a decent story in there. It looks like there's some really epic action. It looks like it's like really bombastic kind of fun, which you would hope you would get in a superhero movie. And obviously the first one was very, very lucrative and very, very successful. $1.1 billion worldwide revenue is nothing to sneeze at, and I imagine they would love to duplicate that after all the flops that they've had over the past 24 months within the DCEU. I don't imagine that's going to happen, especially if they're killing off a baby in the actual movie. Hopefully, common sense has prevailed and they decided not to do that, but this has been a very troubled production. But we have also seen amazing films come out of troubled productions. I imagine all of you know about the things that happened with Apocalypse Now and Abyss and The Shining and a lot of these other really classic movies that had bad productions, but the final product ended up being amazing. I personally like World War Z, which came out not that long ago, starring Brad Pitt, based on the book that was like the oral history of the zombie apocalypse or whatever it was. They had to scrap the entire ending of that movie because it was too bleak and it didn't work for test screeners. They had to go back to the drawing board, think of a new ending for the movie that was a little bit more optimistic than the original one. And I don't think you can really tell it in the end product. It feels like a really good cohesive movie. And there was a good director on that movie as well. So hopefully we get something more like that than what we got with Flash, which was another troubled production. Unfortunately, Flash is a DCEU movie. Aquaman is a DCEU movie. But hopefully James Wan was able to bring this one home. The trailer also teased that the film will see Arthur balancing his duties of both King of Atlantis and a new father. The movie has also been described by Wan as a bromance action adventure, primarily exploring the relationship between Arthur and Orm, which may mean Mira and Aquababy won't be prominently featured. Aquaman and the Lost Kingdom will release in theaters on December 20th, 2023. And you certainly see elements of that in the trailer itself. The most interesting, engaging stuff in the trailer is probably when Aquaman says, "I don't know nothing about that black trident, but I think I know somebody who might." And next thing you know, you see Orm all disheveled with long hair. Obviously, Aquaman is freeing Orm from whatever his captivity is to go on this this adventure where they're gonna go discover, I guess, the origins of Black Manta from destroying everything. Apparently, he's become a bigger threat. He's more powerful. And there's a good chance that Aquaman and Orm kind of doing what Aquaman and Mira did in the first movie that I didn't think really worked because they had no chemistry together will work. Because I do think the chemistry between Aquaman and Orm, even though I don't think Patrick Wilson is the perfect actor for Orm, I don't find him intimidating, like, as a villain. But as a reluctant, like, bromance guy next to Aquaman, I think that could be a lot of fun. So I'm not counting this movie out yet. There's certainly been a lot of negative publicity about it. The trailer effects looked really bad, and there's been something that smells really off about the film. The three sets of reshoots don't sound good. The people leaving the screening sounds really, really bad. And everything kind of leading up to this hasn't been very good. What's the last DCEU movie you really like? I mean, I guess I kind of like Shazam Fury of the Gods, but I guess at this point, the expectations are so low that even if Aquaman and Lost Kingdom isn't just downright bad, maybe it'll be okay. Maybe it'll be acceptable. Will it make money? That's the big thing. Will people be drawn into the theater to support the final DCEU movie, the sequel to a $1.1 billion mega-performing superhero movie? I don't think so. And if they're killing the baby in the movie, there's no way that's going to happen. People are going to start talking about it, and they're going to be very turned off to that for the most part, there will be some crazy people out there be like, oh yes, baby killing. And that sounds like a lot of fun. And I will say this, just as a side note, because it does kind of pertain to what we are talking about here. We do know that Tom King, who's a comic book writer for DC Comics, is in the writer's room developing all the concepts and helping develop the stories for these new DCU movies. Not the DCEU stuff, but the DCU movies moving forward with James Gunn. There is one thing, well, I guess it's two things that Tom King really likes to do in his comic books. He likes character deconstruction. He likes to take your heroes, what you liked about them. He likes to remove that from them and then just kind of break them to pieces. He doesn't ever build the backup, but he also loves killing babies in his comic books. He likes to show babies being killed in his comic books. He likes to talk about babies being killed in his comic books. And he even likes to have like little kids, you know, trying to commit suicide and stuff like that in his comic books. It's been very prevalent throughout his entire run as a DC Comics writer. And we do know that he is one of the guys that's coming up with ideas with James Gunn in the DCU. So there's a good chance if there's a baby dying in Aquaman the Lost Kingdom, it won't be the last one. We'll be getting some more babies being killed in the DCU movies because Tom King is there. And that is something that he absolutely loves to do. He likes to kill kids because it's the only way that he knows to actually get people to buy into the stakes of the story and make you actually feel anything, because Tom King is not a very good writer. He's a one-note pony and he can't do anything new. Now, as far as this, we did talk recently with my good friend Aaron Sparrow on the channel about something smelling off about Aquaman. We hadn't got the trailer yet. We had only gotten the teaser trailer at that point, but it was a very good conversation talking to him about all the things going on with Aquaman and why this doesn't feel like it's going to be the huge hit it probably should be. There's also a link in the video description.